Yeah, welcome. A new Blitz video, and it's again some guy from. This is Denmark. I'm sorry. I was misreading this flag as Norwegian again. I actually can't tell them apart. I was just sloppy at looking. Slav. I really often played the exchange and with some success, but I don't want to do that so much on video anymore. It feels rather dry. Yeah, here E3 95. Which one? I don't know both lines well. I often went for, as mentioned, the exchange or lines with an early E3, so I don't have any big experience in these lines. Yeah, how does white continue here? I know there's knight d7 and castles. Queen e2 is one idea. Okay, let's play queen to e2. Yeah, I think this is one main line. Now maybe bishop f4 looks like a normal move. Yeah, in general, the idea of black in this line is to, yeah, play in a sort of hyper-modern way using the bishops b4 and g6. The g6 bishop often comes to h5 also. Using those pieces to pressurize white's center, and here he even went for c5. Which is not happening too often, which can be Yeah, what I wanted to say is this can be explained by the fact that I may be playing bad moves, and normally black doesn't manage to play this, or it could simply be bad. I don't know. I'm wondering about knight to a2. If this is an idea, maybe he can play just bishop a5. Okay, I need to play at some point. Okay, so what now? We take on c5. He probably just recaptures. Then I have bishop b5, attacking the rook and threatening b4. So it gets tactical, messy. Just attacking the rook, and if he plays, let's say knight f3d7, I'm playing b4 and win this piece. So he sacrifices material very quickly. He would always, I don't know. I'm simply a different kind of player, it seems. I would. Before I'm giving away my stuff, I would invest a bit of time, but maybe this is just wrong. So b4 or takes on e8 or rook d1. I mean, all those moves are possible. If I take on e8, there's maybe bishop d3, but this then queen e3. Cannot believe this. Take e8, come on. I still have b4 in this position. Yeah, now I'm attacking c5. At the moment, I could have also taken f7, maybe with the idea knight e5, but seemed too complicated. I mean, at the moment, I'm a rook up, so if I return some bits of material, it's not such a problem. Okay, So he wants to move the knight, or maybe just a5. Huh? If he moves the knight, I can take the bishop. I'm a rook up. Just need to mention this again. Okay. Ja, Queen D4 probably. There's also always this Bishop F7. I'm not sure if I should spend this time. Okay, there's also this hanging. Yeah, now Bishop F7 really is a move because of Knight G5. But there's also b6 hanging. All kinds of pieces are hanging. Okay, let's take here. Then I'm what at the moment? Two pieces up. And to quote Tali, can take only one at a time. My extra material. So let's just come on, take this and take here, and it's the a pawn. On a7, I hope this counts for something. Yeah, it does. Yeah, maybe this wasn't really working. Not sure. Computer likes it. Knight c takes e4 and wants to play with compensation. Yeah, maybe. Putting the bishop on b6 and trying to get something also on f2. Knight c4, bishop b6. Yeah, not too bad. It's possible. But the game, I think, wasn't b takes. Now queen e8, computer. With equality, but this loses. Bishop f7. Yeah, I saw that, but I thought this also would work. Okay. Yeah, it seems I never really gave away much of my advantage. It was just multiple ways to win. Yeah, thanks for watching.